Welcome to the Juniper Network's KBTV SRX series. This video will show you how to configure your syslog to display VPN status messages. For a text version of these instructions, please refer to article KB10097. The URL is provided at the end of this video. Problem: your VPN is down or not active. To troubleshoot this problem, it is helpful to view the VPN status messages, which are the kmd syslog messages on the responder device, the VPN device that is receiving the setup request. By default, VPN status messages aren't logged in the syslog. Therefore, this video will show you how to configure a new syslog file that only captures the VPN status messages so you can quickly identify why your VPN is down. There are three parts to your solution. We will first review the default syslog level. Then we will configure a new syslog file. This will be called kmd-logs and will capture the status messages for VPN events. Finally, we will view the kmd-logs file to see that status messages are being received, so we can find out why the VPN is down. Let's review the default syslog level. In Junos OS, VPN events are written to the syslog file named messages. By default, only critical level messages are written to the syslog file. The problem is that VPN status messages are written at the info level. Since they aren't critical, if your configuration is using the default syslog config, VPN status messages will not be logged. This leads us to the objective of this video, which is to configure a new syslog file named kmd-logs to capture VPN status messages. Recall that the responder device is the receiving side of the VPN. This is the side that receives the tunnel setup request, not the side that initiates the tunnel setup request. On the responder device, navigate to the system syslog stanza and create a new file, kmd-logs, with the following two options. The daemon level must be set to info, and it must be set to match the keyword kmd. Note that the keyword kmd must be in uppercase. Commit the configuration. The file kmd-logs is written to the var log directory. From this point on, the file kmd-logs will capture any VPN events initiated or negotiated with the SRX device. Before we view the kmd-logs file, you may be asking, what is the difference between the kmd and kmd-logs syslog file? The kmd file is where Ike traceoptions or Ike debugs are stored, whereas the new syslog file that we created in this video captures a high-level view of VPN events. You can use both files for troubleshooting. Most likely you would start with the high-level view of the problem by viewing the kmd-logs file. For detailed troubleshooting, you would configure Ike traceoptions and view that information in the kmd file with the command show log kmd. Now let's view the kmd-logs. After you've committed your configuration, recreate your VPN connection issue by attempting to establish the VPN. Then check the logs by issuing the command show log kmd logs. The file kmd logs will be populated when there is Ike negotiation taking place across any VPN on the device. As you can see from this log output, the Ike phase 2 negotiation fails because the peer proxy IDs do not match. This shows you why the VPN has failed. You have the messages. Now how do you analyze them? For additional help troubleshooting these Ike Phase 1 and Ike Phase 2 messages in the KMD logs file, refer to KB10101 for Ike Phase 1 issues or KB10099 for Ike Phase 2 issues. For more information, such as the text format of this video, more KBTV technical videos, and our support site, you can visit these URLs. Thank you for watching.